everyone, my name is Eric. Thank you for joining me on One Smoker's Palate, and you are watching Oakland Tobacconist. Now, we've named this title, this series, One Smoker's Palate, because that's all this is. This is a list that's going to be built on preference. Palates are different. Maybe something you really enjoy may not be my palate, and vice versa. And so, going through this next dawn of 2022, as some of you have seen, I put out a video of trying to find the best Mexican San Andreas that I can find that suits my palate for the year of 2022. Again, it's subjective. It's based on what I am tasting. And so today, I have the first San Andreas that I am going to review here on the channel to begin this long journey of great tobacco. Whether we're in the DR, in Nicaragua, Honduras, and beyond, I want to see what is the best blend using the San Andreas as the wrapper leaf. And so today is the first. I'm going to try to make about three of these videos a month, try three top videos, and of course, if I have this cigar available, check us out at oaklandtobacconist.com. That's where you can pick it up. Today is such the case. In fact, it is a new one that we just got in. This is distributed through Privada Cigar Club. This is the Bonita 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 San Andreas Maduro. It's got binder and fillers from the DR, and then the wrapper itself is a Mexican San Andreas. So with that said, we'll get into the history of the cigar, but I'm gonna go ahead and light it up. Let's go dive right into our review. On the dry draw, there's a lot of earth, and like cocoa powder. I won't say, sometimes with San Andreas, you have a lot of like pepper on the tongue. That's very minimal, very, very minimal spice on the lips. But I will say definitely cocoa powder. So it's not like a dark chocolate, but it's kind of a light sprinkling with a lot of earth in there too. I will also say right off the bat, the draw is open. So that's always great. I am not a fan of a super tight draw. So having a wide open draw is great. This Bonita 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 is a Robusto, I believe 5x52. Okay, so the pepper is a perfect balance. There's a little bit there, but it's not gonna overwhelm your palate. There's that cocoa sweetness there, a little bit of earth, and there's almost like a sour note. Now, sometimes sour can sound negative. In this case, I think it works. In fact, one of the cigars that I really enjoy that has a slight sour note to it that's just kind of through is the Desvalido from Dapper Cigar Company. Really good balance and blend. But I'm gonna take a second puff. Let's see second impressions. Really interesting because I feel like there's a good amount of strength behind it, but it's also very smooth. That's somewhat of a buzzword for me when people say, hey, this is just a really smooth, great cigar. And I think it's because that's my palate doesn't always look for smooth. To me, that doesn't constitute as a great cigar. For some, it does, and some that works. But oftentimes, I prefer a medium plus. This has a good amount of strength behind it, but it's not too aggressive. You have that sour note, you have that cocoa note, a good amount of like Maduro sweetness. And I wonder if that's coming out because the fillers and the binder is Dominican. So it's kind of taming some of that San Andreas tobacco. This cigar is aged for 7 months. It comes from the Tabacalera La Isla, which is a small factory in the DR. And it's run by a gentleman named Hostos, who is actually the cousin of Terence Riley with Aganorsa Leaf. This was first commissioned to be created by Privada Cigar Club. So this was seen and released to all Privada members, and it's available here at OGT. I want to see exactly what it's about. So we're only in the first third. Let's see what happens when we get into the second third. All right, so we are in the second third, and this is what I'll say. The high marks for this cigar is that it's a really good blend of like cocoa sweetness, having the pepper very minimal, but you get a lot of that chocolate through the retro. So if you retrohale, this is it's highlighted when it's retrohaled. It's definitely satisfying on that end. The balance of flavors too is what really works for this. It's not gonna be overly strong. I would say medium to medium plus in strength, probably full bodied in flavor. The ash is holding on. I actually haven't had to correct it, so it gets high marks for the ash, but it looks like it's probably going to be dropping off here soon. I had to set it down a few times, but it's still holding on. Burn seems to do really well. There's no correction there. And smoke output and draw is very satisfying. So overall, it's a completely well-constructed cigar. when it comes to San Andreas. This is what I'll also say, is along with all these flavors, it's a very different take. The shade of the tobacco itself is on the lighter side. It's not too dark. Sometimes you find San Andreas with like a really rustic look or very toothy. This is a very smooth, almost seamless looking wrapper, very light, but it's delivering in the flavor. I really enjoy just the hint of punch that I get behind it on strength, and then the smoothness of flavor just kind of comes all together. So for being 7 months aged tobacco and being released, I am impressed with the way this cigar is holding up in terms of construction and flavor balance. That's not always the case you're going to find with San Andreas. Sometimes it's more forward on that push of pepper, sometimes more just chocolatey notes, but it's playing with them really well. And this is also very satisfying if you're sort of looking for something either different or something for the first time in that kind of like strength-wise level. And I think that the Dominican tobacco in this cigar is what's calming it to be more smooth, more balanced, and all around more of just a flavor punch more than strength-wise. So really, really good. This is almost an anytime cigar in the sense of you could probably have it in the morning. It might be a little strong, but morning with coffee or even to close down the evening. But I'm really satisfied so far with the burn and the draw and the smoke output. So I'm going to continue to smoke on this, and we will see where it lands us in the next third. Okay, here we are, final third. Unfortunately, the ash did drop, but as I said, I saw that kind of coming, but it's very, very like tight and very like clear on the white side. It's not a dirty side to it. Burn line continues to be well. And really, I mean, the flavors of the like cocoa sweetness and that kind of earth are really intensifying. But what works really well in this blend is that the closer we come down to the bottom, it's intensifying but not becoming bitter. And a lot of times you run into that, especially on lighter cigars, is that it becomes really hot, you can't hold it, or it becomes so bitter that you don't want to continue to smoke it. That's not the case of this. In fact, the sweetness is kind of ramping up too. So honestly, I would say its higher marks are in the final third. And when it comes to our rating system here, we're very, very conservative on the rating side. A lot of times you're gonna see a lot of like high-end ratings are gonna be upper 80s, low-ends are probably gonna be like lower 60s. It's very different than what you might see on Half Wheel and other channels. But I prefer if a cigar is gonna be so amazing, that bar's gotta be set really high. And we have 10 different categories. That ranges from first third, second third, final third, cold draw, aroma, what's on the nose, the entire thing. 10 different categories, and out of those, it came in at a 74. Most of the high ratings that I gave this cigar was on the draw, the smoke output, the ash construction seems to be completely on point, and the final third. The final third got its top rating, which kind of pushed it into the 74 range. I'm going to continue to smoke San Andreas. We'll see if anything can dethrone the Bonita at 74, but an awesome cigar. I encourage you guys to check this out. If you want to try it yourself, kind of see what it's all about, it's worth trying. So thank you again for smoking along with me. As always, I'm Eric, and you have been watching Oakland Tobacconist.